Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe No Man, welcome to our reaction to Tom Jones.
Tom Jones
is back on the Cafe No Man.
Sir Tom Jones back in the house, yeah. The Tower of Song. The first time single take honest reaction for Babadook. Let's get started.
Whoa, what was that? Did I miss something?
Let's get started. I don't know how to pronounce this requester's or patron's names. I'm just calling something similar that I know. Okay. Babadook, Dook, Dook.
That's a movie.
So, if you would like to support honest reviews, unscripted, impromptu, just like we are, and it's like every single video on our channel, definitely check out our Patreon page. We have been thriving at times on this dishonest roller coaster like platform called YouTube, where the algorithm prefers scripted videos, fake, totally dishonest. That's what YouTube and YouTubers thrive on. So we are a rare breed, and definitely we will not do well on this platform. We've done well despite the odds being against us, thanks to you and only due to you. More than 6,000 paid requests fulfilled in the last 4 years. No other YouTuber in the history of YouTube has accomplished what we have with this feat. We don't need any awards. We don't want any awards. We refuse all awards.
Because we are
above all that. We are above all that, Kirti. Yeah. There's a way around it. We are above all that. Just like Sir Tom Jones, we are so excited to listen to his voice once again. Similarly, Queen Kirti and King Savio are above all the fake, dishonest, scripted YouTubers out there. We are above all that. But we do enjoy being on YouTube. We do enjoy being here, and we are very grateful for this opportunity.
We are cribbing because we need a button maybe.
We are grateful for this opportunity to listen to one more song along with you guys. Especially of a song of Sir Tom Jones.
Yeah.
Oh, how biased it all sounds. But mark my words. If I don't like something about the song, or he doesn't sing it as well as we did the last three or four times, I'm going to say I don't like it.
Yeah. But he's a great singer.
That's how we are.
Well, my friends are gone and my hair is gray. I ache in the places where I used to play, and I'm crazy for love, but I'm not coming home. I'm just paying my rent every day in the Tower of Song. I said to Hank Williams, how lonely does it get? Hank Williams hasn't answered me yet, but I hear him coughing all night long. 100 floors above me in the Tower of Song. I was born like this, I had no choice. I was born with a gift of a golden voice and 27 angels from the great beyond. They tied me to the stage right here in the Tower of Song. So you can stick your little pins in that voodoo doll. I'm very sorry, baby, but that doesn't look like me at all. And I'm standing by the window where the light is strong. They don't let women kill you, not here in the Tower of Song. Now you can say that I've grown bitter, but this you can be sure. The rich have got their channels in the bedrooms of the poor, and there's a mighty judgment coming, babe. But I may be wrong. You see, you hear these funny voices in a tower of song. I see you standing on the other side. I don't know how the river got so wide. And I loved you, baby, way back when. And all the bridges are burning that we might have crossed. But I feel so close to everything we lost. And we'll never have to lose it again. Now I bid you farewell. I don't know when I'll be back. They're moving us tomorrow to the tower down the track, and you'll be hearing from me, baby, long after I'm gone. I'll be speaking to you sweetly from a window in the tower of song.
Yes, yes, yes. Oh!
What happened?
What's this?
Oh, no.
An abrupt ending. Oh, it's the second time it has happened recently.
Yeah, was it actually over?
Ending. Oh! The person who made this video doesn't like Savio De Silva for sure. Doesn't like Enoma for sure. Oh, how can you do this with such a powerful voice resounding in my ears till now? How can you end the song like this? Oh, this is a great song. I'll definitely listen to the whole thing.
I know.
It is packed with substance, which is so unlike most of the songs that we have heard in recent times. Packed with substance, wisdom. Referencing Hank Jones, has a little bit of country. Hank Williams, referencing a little bit of country music in there, a little bit of pop rock. Oh, and his voice and that guitar tune playing hypnotically in a trance-like manner in the background. Oh, this is beautiful music. This is beautiful music. This is created for the love of music, which is given a cute little name. The Tower of Song. So it's all for the love of music, the love of the career of music, the passion for music, and this is all about that. Ah, beautiful, beautiful. Recently we heard a song about rock and roll, which had very little rock and roll in it. But this is the exact opposite. It's about the Tower of Song, and it sticks to it being about the Tower of Song. The power of the tower and the power of this song will be in our memory lifelong. I'm no Sir Tom Jones here. I'm no Sir Elton John. I'm no Sir, basically. I can't do what these guys do. I can't do what Tom Jones did. But I absolutely love listening to every little word and every little second of this song.
Yes.
Shame on you for giving us an uncut video. I mean, a cut video.
It could be a mistake on our side too.
A video which is not complete. Shame on you. If it was me who did that or anybody else, shame on me. But definitely we'll hear the whole song.
Yeah.
Let's see what Queen Kirti has to say about this. Well, about the song, that is.
I'm not gonna, you know, talk about Tom Jones's voice because it is amazing. It is amazing. And I'm also not going to talk about the music, which you already mentioned. The lyrics of the song was so deep, and the way he sang it forces you. I don't know whether it forced you or not, but the way the lines were written and the way he started singing, it was so candid on his part that it forced me also to think about when he mentioned Hank Williams and, you know, how does it feel like when you are in, you know, at that point in your age and in your life. How does it feel like? What are the things that may happen to you? It forced me as a young woman to also think about those days. What will happen? What am I going to see or feel or think about? Or how will it be exactly? It did force me to do that. And it also forced me to reflect upon the things that happened in the past as well. I remember Tom Jones, this was the first time that we were listening to him, Delilah. No, I think before that we had reacted to another song, but
green,
it was
green,
way back,
grass,
yeah,
phone.
Way back, a couple of years ago. Since we are, you know, celebrating the anniversary of Enoma on YouTube.
Fourth anniversary.
These things come to mind.
Less than 0.2% of YouTubers last 4 years.
Okay.
Less than 0.2% of YouTubers. We're talking about millions of YouTubers since 2007. Yeah. Less than 0.2% have lasted more than 4 years, especially making videos as regularly as we have, almost every day. Less than 0.2%. I would say 0.1% maybe. But let's give the benefit of the doubt to the fact that these statistics are not even maintained by YouTube. They don't care about longevity. They want you to just... they don't respect people like us. They don't respect. And that can be seen. People don't like hanging around on YouTube for too long.
It sounds like an impossible thing to know.
We love music. So we love music and we love Sir Tom Jones and his voice and the lyrics. The substance in the lyrics is absolutely off the charts. The lyricism in this one is off the charts. Off the records. Off the records.
So, you know, when we were reacting
off the charts rather, not off the records.
Things happen now, even with us as reactors, and especially me being completely new to everything, especially Western music. Initially, it was difficult. It was difficult to understand. Yeah, what was being sung, what is the context? What does it mean? Why it is sung the way it is sung? And it has been challenging. It has been definitely challenging. Even now, we sometimes it's difficult for us to get things as well as people from that part of the world could get. Maybe because you live there, we don't. You get the cultural part and everything, we don't. It's a way of, you know, looking at things and perspectives. So I was mentioning about Delilah when, you know, the funniest part. Just because the song was Candid, and, you know, I feel prompted to share it. I wasn't actually going with the flow of the lyrics in that one because the music was mariachi and it was quite rich.
And the voice.
And the voice. And I was awestruck by the voice itself. So I wasn't really following the lyrics as I should have, but it does not go as you plan. Always, and not with every song that
and
you're listening
our reactions
to.
More or less
and
are totally
are actually,
unplanned,
yeah, doing
unscripted.
First time, we don't.
That's
do
why
it
people
again.
Love us. We are the only reactors in the history of YouTube, or reaction channel in the history of YouTube that has got more than 6,000 paid requests. Only channel. Find anyone else, and we'll definitely have a collaboration
although
with them sometime
amounts,
in the future.
But yes.
Small amounts, pitiful amounts at least. But so, we are the only ones which have stuck around this long and done that many requests. That itself shows how much we love music and love the work that we do. We have great respect and admiration for artists and musicians who have as much discipline as we have in our own profession and our own lives.
When I watched that reaction, Delilah, on YouTube myself, the evening that it really, you know, it comes out in the evening here, mostly our time evening. So I'm sitting here
late
and watching the video, and I see myself clapping at a point at the most awkward point in the song.
The
and I didn't know why did I do that. I didn't know what happened. Why was I clapping at, right at that point when he's singing about, you know, putting the knife in the woman's body, and I'm sitting and clapping there with all the joy and happiness.
And there were comments about that too. We incidentally happened to take we took that video offline.
Yeah, we did.
We just didn't just take it offline
because of the timing
like
of the
we often do, but we actually deleted it. So it was one of those rare videos that we deleted for simply the reason that Kirti, with her totally impromptu, unscripted review, clapped when the knife was going in through a woman's body.
I was completely unaware of what was happening in the lyrics at that time. I was, you know, happy about the music, the way it was being sung and everything. So the journey has been amazing. It has been colorful. It has been quite an experience and a ride of reacting to music.
There are more than 5,000 plus good songs remaining as per our list at least of request. So it just needs to be requested by someone or the other and us to get down to doing it. So if we actually fulfill those 5,000 more requests, adding it to the 7,000 plus that we've done totally paid as well as unpaid or free, I think we'll be around for another 5 years at least, 5 to 10 years. Hopefully, if we are alive and YouTube is and if YouTube is still around,
I think.
Because the way things are going and the way YouTube functions, it's a serious doubt in my mind whether YouTube will be around in 5 to 10 years time.
I don't know. Things improve and things upgrade as well. So, I can't tell anything about the future. We were reacting to Lita Ford for the first time again. me listening to Lita Ford with Ozzy Osbourne. And you remember, I didn't realize there was Lita Ford in the song.
Yeah, you thought it was a male singer.
It was the same singer. All the way, just Ozzy Osbourne.
When I close my eyes forever. Something like that, this song. I still remember it. Beautiful voices, both of this.
Yeah.
If only they just sang like that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful, beautiful.
So this is the Tower of Song. I got into the Tower of Reactions that we have built. You're looking down from the window.
Yeah. It's personal. On Enoma, it's personal. For others, it's impersonal. For us, it's personal. It's, we talk about ourselves. We talk about the way we do things. We talk about each other. We talk about music. And we talk. We really talk. We discuss. And that discussion's at point in the West where there's freedom of speech is seriously lacking these days. And openness is seriously lacking in the UK and USA. Definitely it doesn't, people over there don't like when we have that kind of freedom in this part of the world today. So we are very lucky to belong to a country which promotes freedom of speech and be on a platform itself that promotes freedom of speech in our part of the world. Because, you know, in their part of the world, that freedom does not exist.
No, I think the freedom of speech people over there think that the freedom of speech is only for the citizens of their country and not of another country or another side of the
part of
the
world. Of a particular race.
Yeah, exactly.
Certain races are allowed to speak freely.
And
certain skin colors or races.
That other people should not be speaking what they think. When I say that is called freedom of expression, when others say it's whatever it is. Yeah.
Yeah, overall, we love this song. I love the voice of Tom Jones. I love the song. Kirti loved the lyrics, loved the voice. We loved it. You react, you request songs like these on Patreon by choosing a tie. Oh, you will love our responses too. You will love these reviews. I tell you, you will never hear a single negative thing from our mouths. Especially mine.
Songs are gonna be
you will see me as happy as you see me now. So to see me this happy, once again, request a good song like this. Or request a Tom Jones song. Oh, I'm biased. What can I do? When it comes to Tom Jones and our vocalists like this, I have an inherent bias. It's not a bias for Tom Jones per se. It's a bias for good music. Great music. And that's why the Queen of England also thought him worthy of knighthood.
Thank you for watching. We'll be right back.